Welcome you all to today's discussion. It is the continuation of previous day's discussion of surgical instrument. That's why it's part two and it will be continued. The topics of discussion are shown in right side of the screen. First, we shall discuss about Bart Parker handle. It may be different size written over its body, maybe 3, number 4. These two are commonly used, and also maybe 5 and 7 in number. And they will be attached with surgical blade. The surgical blade again may be in different shape and size, and also these are according to its number written over it and also over its foil. BP handles are different in size and their size is written over its handle. It is a flat instrument with one side is narrow and there is a slot in narrow side in both side for engagement of a BP blade or surgical blade. The surgical blade also be different in size and it is written over its foil. The number is written over its foil, like this is number 11, and also it is written over the blade. The BP handle is sterilized by autoclaving and the BP blade or surgical blade is pre-sterilized pack in industry by gamma radiation. The technique of opening this foil of surgical blade is pull like this and hold the blade with hemostatic forceps. Then position the blade with the help of dissecting forceps. This is a number 10 size blade. It will be attached with handle number 3. Remember that the number 3 handle is for blade number 10, 11, 12 and 15. This blade will be engaged in this slot. But if you use another number of handle more than 3, it will not be in same size. So before attaching a blade, you should match the number of BP blade and handle. First, look, this slot will be matched with this blade, but if it is not matched with this blade, like this in position, then you must position the blade with the help of dissecting forceps. Always remember, never hold sharp with your hand and engage the blade along the slot of handle. This is the slot. There will be a click sound when it is attached with its handle. When you pass the handle to others, you must not push the blade forwards to your assistant because it can injure him. Always push like handle first, like this. And it is better to use a kidney tray to handle any sharp to avoid injury. on removal of a BB blade from its handle, you will just hold the base of the handle with hemostat and lift it a little bit to disengage the base. Then again hold the blade forward and pull the handle backwards. Not push the blade forward, because if you push the blade forward, you may injure someone. And always remember, when you will discard a sharp instrument, always use a sharp discarding container like this. Number 4 BP handle will be attached with surgical blade number 18, 20, 22 and 24. When you will make a incision with BP blade and handle, there may be two types. When you give an incision over abdomen, a large incision, then you will be hold the BP blade and handle like this and use the index finger to stabilize the blade like this. You must not take incision like this to injure with your thumb or index finger. When you will do a fine work with fine scalpel handle, then hold it like pen holding manner and stabilize the it with this little finger like this action. We use this BP blade and handle to make incision in all operations. We drain abscess by giving incision with this BP blade and handle. It is used to make incision over skin to insert a drain. We also sharp dissection do with blade and handle in mastectomy, sebaceous cyst, lipoma, and also skin flaps raised by plastic surgeons with this BP blade. In appendicectomy operation, we cut the appendix with this BP blade. We also cut the cystic duct in cholecystectomy operation with this blade. Butt Parker blade and handle is commonly associated with incisions, and these are the common abdominal incisions. The midline incision. The midline incision may extend from GP sternum to pubic symphysis, and it may be upper midline, mid-midline, or lower midline, depending on the need for surgeon. It is the preferred incision for emergency laparotomy because it has rapid access. After skin and subcutaneous tissue, cut the linea alba, fossa transversalis, and parietal peritoneum in single layer. So, rapid access. Again, closure is also rapid. First layer close the mass closure of peritoneum, fossa transversalis, and linea alba, and then skin and subcutaneous tissue is closed. As the single layer is cut, the linea alba, so less chance of wound infection in this incision. But as this area is relatively avascular, so more chance of incisional hernia formation. But with the advent of newer suture materials like polypropylene, polydioxanone, this possibility of incisional hernia is almost now nil. The upper midline incision is used commonly for stomach, duodenum, or pancreatic operation. As we know, it is used for emergency laparotomy, so we commonly use this operation for perforation of gas-containing hollow viscus or intestinal obstruction. We commonly repair the duodenal ulcer perforation by this incision. We do the gastrojejunostomy by this incision. The lower midline incision some surgeons use for open prostatectomy or suprapubic cystolithotomy. Our next incision is paramedian incision. Paramedian incision is 2 to 3 centimeter lateral to midline. So it may be right or left, it may be upper or lower paramedian incision. The paramedian incision cut the skin and subcutaneous tissue, then cut the anterior layer of rectus sheath. Rectus abdominis muscle is retracted laterally to avoid injury of intercostal vein and intercostal vessels and nerves. Then cut the posterior layer of rectus sheath with fossa transversalis and parietal peritoneum, and abdominal cavity is approached. And again on closer, first layer close the peritoneum, fossa transversalis and posterior layer of rectus sheath, and second layer close the anterior layer of rectus sheath, then skin and subcutaneous tissues close. The right paramedian incision is commonly used for cholecystectomy, choledocholithotomy, right heavy colectomy. Left subcostal may be used for, left paramedian may be used for splenectomy, left hemicolectomy. Our next incision is subcostal incision. The subcostal incision, which may be right and left. Right subcostal incision is known as Cocker's incision. This incision is 2 to 3 cm below and parallel with the costal margin. It may extend from midline to anterior axillary fold. It cuts the skin subcutaneous tissue, then anterior layer of rectus sheath. Rectus abdominis muscle is transected, but remember, when cut the rectus abdominis muscle, it's not retract because it is attached with the rectus sheath by tendinous intersections. Then cut the posterior layer of rectus sheath with fossa transversalis and parietal peritoneum, and then peritoneal cavity is approached. And again on closer, first layer repair the peritoneum with posterior layer of rectus sheath. Remember, rectus abdominis muscle is not sutured, no suture is required to repair the rectus abdominis muscle. And second layer, close the anterior layer of rectus sheath, then the subcutaneous skin is closed. If the incision extends more laterally, then cut the external oblique, internal oblique, transverse abdominis, and then peritoneum. And again, on closer, first layer from inner side, the peritoneum, transversalis abdominis and internal oblique muscle, and then external oblique muscle. Remember, the intercostal vessel and nerve lie in between transversalis abdominis and internal oblique. Right subcostal incision is commonly used for cholecystectomy, cholecystectomy. Left subcostal incision may be used for splenectomy. Our next incision is gridiron incision, the classical incision for appendicectomy. The incision centered on McBurney's point, which is at junction at medial 2/3 and lateral 1/3 junction of line joining anterior superior spine to umbilicus, the spino-umbilical line, and this gridiron incision is at the right angle of this line. It cut the skin subcutaneous tissue, then external oblique aponeurosis along the direction of its fiber. Internal oblique and transversus abdominis muscle is split, and then fossa transversalis and peritoneum is then cut in single layer to enter into the peritoneal cavity. And again on closer, first layer the parietal peritoneum with fossa transversalis, then internal oblique and transversus abdominis that was splitted, this opposed with absorbable sutures, and finally the external oblique apodosis is closed. If this incision needs to extend, it can be extended laterally by muscle cutting incision. Then it is known as Rutherford-Morrison incision. Another incision is commonly used for appendicectomy. The incision which is more cosmetically acceptable and transverse incision is known as Lenz incision. It's centered on mid-clavicular, mid-inguinal line about 2 cm below the level of umbilicus. It's a transverse incision, so it is cosmetically more better and it lies below the bikini line. For inguinal hernia operation, we commonly use the inguinal incision, which is 2 to 3 cm above and parallel with the inguinal ligament. That may be left or right. For nephrolithotomy or pyelolithotomy, we use loin or lumbar muscle cutting incision. It starts from the lateral border of the erectrospinae muscle and extend forwards in between iliac crest and costal margin. And the transverse incision. Transverse incision again may be upper transverse, infraumbilical transverse, or suprapubic transverse incision. Upper transverse incision is commonly used for operation of the pancreas, stomach. Some surgeons used to this for cholecystectomy as the cosmetically it's better result. Infra-umbilical transverse incision commonly used by pediatric surgeons for exploratory laparotomy of pediatric age patients. Suprapubic transverse incision is more favorable incision for gynecologists and obstetricians, and they term it Fennin steel incision, and the spelling of Fennin steel is also preferred by them, the PFANNENSTIEL Fennin steel. This transverse incision is cosmetically more acceptable because it forms less scar as it is lies in skin crease line. In transverse incision, after skin and subcutaneous tissue, we cut the anterior layer of rectus sheath. Then rectus abdominis muscle is also cut and posterior layer of rectus sheath with peritoneum. And again on closer, the same posterior layer is closed. Then rectus sheath, no suture mark in rectus abdominis muscle, and then anterior layer of rectus sheath, skin and subcutaneous tissue. Some surgeons prefer to retract the rectus abdominis muscle laterally in suprapubic transverse incision.
These are dissecting forceps. It may be plain dissecting forceps or tooth dissecting forceps. Its another variation is Edson's forceps. As these are the blunt instruments, these are sterilized by autoclaving. This is plain dissecting forceps. It has serration at the inner side of the blade near its tip, but in tooth dissecting forceps compared to it, it has tooth and groove at its tip to hold the top structures. And another type of forceps is Edson's forceps, which has pointed tip but near the grip of the handle it is broad. The plain dissecting forceps is used to hold any delicate structure like peritoneum, vessel, nerve. In appendicectomy, we hold the cecum to deliver the appendix, and then we use a long plain forceps. We also use it to hold the gut margin for gut anastomosis and gastrojejunostomy. The fine-tipped forceps often used for nerve repair and vascular anastomosis. The tooth forceps is used to hold tough structures like linea alba, rectus sheath. During skin closure, we hold the skin with this tooth forceps. We hold the scalp for scalp closure with this forceps. For circumcision, we hold the prepuce for suturing with this tooth forceps. We often use two types of scissors. One is fine scissors and another is rough scissors. As these are sharp instruments, we use chemical sterilization technique, commonly used Lysol or glutaraldehyde solution. Rough scissors are robust and heavy, but plain scissors are beautifully thin and slim, the fine scissor. The rough scissors are used to cut the suture material, the drain tube, the corrugated rubber sheet. It may be used to cut the dressing, and very rarely it can be used to cut the some tough structures like linea alba. When you will cut a suture in depth with scissors, always support the scissor with the index finger of opposite hand to avoid unnecessary movement by the scissor. Fine scissor is used to cut the fine tissue structures. We use this for sharp dissection in mastectomy, thyroidectomy, excision of sebaceous cyst or lipoma, and also raise the flap and sharp dissection in incisional hernia operation. In appendicectomy by gridiron incision, we cut the external oblique aponeurosis with this scissor, peritoneum with this scissor, and also we cut the mesoappendix with this fine scissors. In hernia operation, we cut the external oblique aponeurosis. We dissect the hernial sac by sharp dissection with this fine scissors, and also open the fundus with this. In cholecystectomy operation by subcostal incision, we cut the anterior layer of rectus sheath, the posterior layer of rectus sheath, and also the cystic artery with this fine scissor. The holding of scissor is insert the distal phalanx only in finger bow and stabilize the scissor with the index finger. Not introduce up to the distal phalanx, proximal phalanx, that will be make more difficult to use this scissor. The correct position of finger is distal phalanx, just distal phalanx will enter into the finger bow like this. And again, as a sharp instrument, the scissors should be transferred in kidney tray to other to avoid injury. This is stitch or suture cutting scissors. It may be two type. One type is just like normal scissor, but there is a notch near its tip to grip a suture material. Another type is like this. The handle is beautifully curved. The blades are small and there is serration at the tip of the blade to grip a suture material. And its use to cut stitch on skin or mucosal surface. The stitch cutting is, we first use antiseptic wash to the area. Hold the tip of suture and pass the suture cutting scissor just beneath the knot and cut the suture and pull in this way to avoid more wound gaping. If you pull in this way, the wound gap will be more. So pull in this way and then put it on a gauze pitch. Again, cut just beneath the knot. If we cut in this position, the suture material will run through the tissue and more chance of wound infection. And pull this way. As this is a sharp instrument, so it is sterilized by chemical sterilization, that's Lysol. This is Curette or Bachmann's scoop. It is a long instrument with spoons at the end. They are used to curette non-healing ulcer, abscess cavity, discharging sinus or fistula, and granulation tissue. The orthopedician used this instrument to curette osteomyelitic bones or aneurysmal bone cyst. This is Langenbach's retractor. Its nickname is right angle retractor. This has a long handle with a short flat blade at the tip of the handle and it is attached with the handle at 90 degree angle. The tip of the blade is also curved inward for better retraction. It is used for better visualization of operative field. In appendicectomy, it retracts the layers of the abdominal wall and also it retracts the whole abdominal wall. In inguinal hernia operation, it retracts the different layers for better visualization. Also, it is used any superficial surgery to retract skin, fascia or aponeurosis. This is sterilized by autoclaving. This is Morris retractor. There may be one handle at the end of one blade at the end of handle, or each side of the handle there may be one blade, that's two blade in one handle. This has a long handle with gently curved wide blade and also the tip of the blade is curved inward for better retraction. It is used in laparotomy or appendicectomy to retract the abdominal wall. In cholecystectomy, it retract the right lobe of liver. It retract the pectoralis muscle for axillary dissection in mastectomy. Also used to retract strap muscle and sternocleidomastoid muscle in thyroidectomy. As it is a blunt instrument, it is sterilized by autoclaving. This is diverse retractor. It has a broad S-shaped, gently curved blade. During cholecystectomy, it retracts the right lobe of liver upwards or retract duodenum and stomach downwards. In truncal vagotomy, it retract left lobe of liver. In hemicolectomy and kidney operation, it retract the abdominal wall. In anterior resection or abdominoperineal resection, it retract bladder in male or uterus in female during pelvic dissection. And as a blunt instrument, it is sterilized by autoclaving. This is cat's paw or Bachmann's retractor. It has multiple hooks with pointed or blunt tips. Other side, there may be a small right angle retractor. This may be present or may absent. It is used to retract fascia in sole and palm. Used to retract skin flaps in superficial operations like sebaceous cyst, lipoma, dermoid excision. As a blunt instrument, this is sterilized by autoclaving. This is hook retractor. It has hook at the tip which may be blunt or pointed. This used to raise skin flap by plastic surgeons. Also used to retract skin in sebaceous cyst or lipoma excision. This instrument is sterilized by autoclaving. This is Doyen's retractor. Very favorite instrument for obstetricians. It has a very wide blade and used in pelvic surgery and cesarean section to prevent bladder injury. This instrument is sterilized by autoclaving.
Thank you for watching this video. Stay home and be safe in Corona days.
Thank you.